Hello dear students, good morning and namaste. Myself Bharatendu, lecturer in chemistry from BTC Government Girls Model Senior Secondary School, Nurpur. Today I will help you in understanding the concept solid state chemistry. I hope you will enjoy the topic and complete your assignment well in time. In the present topic, we will discuss about the basic and elementary concepts related to the solid states, the types of solids, the types of crystalline solids. So let us start and enjoy the topic. In the previous class, that is 10 plus 1, we already have discussed about the three states of matter. On the basis of basic force of attraction between the particles, we have three types of states: solids, liquids and gases. In the solids, the particles are very close to each other because they have strong intermolecular forces between them. In case of liquids, particles are a bit apart from each other because they have slightly less force of attraction, whereas in case of gases, the force of attraction is very, very less, hence the particles are very far from each other. So this is about the basic, about the three states of matter. We already have discussed about the three states of matter. The characteristic feature of solids are they have definite volume, definite shape and definite surface. In case of liquids, the volume is definite but shape is indefinite and the surface is flexible. In case of gases, there is indefinite volume, no shape and no surface at all. So this is basic about the three states of matter which we already have discussed in the plus one. In the plus two class, we will mainly discuss about the solid state. On the basis of arrangement of particle and the order of particle, the solids are of two types. One is a crystalline solid and other is the amorphous solid. Crystalline solids are those substances, are those solids in which the constituent particles, the atoms, ions or molecules are arranged in the definite geometry. That is, in the crystalline solid, geometry of the particle is definite. X-ray diffraction studies has revealed that the crystalline solids have long range order, which means the crystals are those substances or those solids which have regular pattern of the arrangement of the particles present in them. Let us discuss the properties of crystalline solid first. Crystalline solids have definite characteristic shapes. They have regular arrangement of the constituent particles. They exhibit a long range order. They have sharp melting and sharp boiling points. They have definite characteristics related to the enthalpy of fusion, that is, have definite enthalpy of fusion. When cut with the help of some tools, they split into two pieces and the newly generated surfaces are plain and smooth. One important property of crystalline solids, that is, they are anisotropic in nature. From the anisotropy, we means different physical properties have different value in different direction. Basically, crystalline solids are regarded as the true solids. The examples are included copper, silver, iron, common salt, zinc sulfate, potassium, nitrate, etc. So all these are the crystalline solids. Let's now discuss about the amorphous solids. Amorphous solids are those solids in which the constituent particles are not arranged in any regular arrangement. While discussing the properties of amorphous solids, the first is about the shape. Amorphous solids have irregular shape. They do not have any regular arrangement of the constituent particles. They may have a short range order. They do not have sharp melting point. They gradually softens over the range of temperature. They do not have the definite enthalpy of fusion. When cut with the help of a sharp edge tool, they cut into two pieces having irregular arrangement. Property wise, they are isotropic in nature, which means they have same value of physical and other properties in all the three directions. Nature wise, they are called as pseudo solids or also called as super cooled liquids. Amorphous solids such as glass, rubber, plastic are used in our daily life because they have unique characteristics. So these were the properties of crystalline solids and the amorphous solids. More emphasis is given on the crystalline solid in the plus two class. So we will mainly discuss about the crystalline solid in the present slide. Further, crystalline solids are classified into four categories, which depends upon the nature of the force and the type of particle present in the solids. Respectively, they are the molecular solids, ionic solids, metallic solids and the covalent solids. Let us discuss first the molecular solids. In the molecular solids, the constituent particles are small molecules and they are held together by the weak forces, the dispersion forces or the London forces. They can be the dipole-dipole forces or simply they can be hydrogen bond. The molecular solids are further classified into nonpolar molecules, polar molecules and hydrogen bonded molecules. In the nonpolar molecules, they are soft in nature, they have low melting and low boiling points, they are liquid at room temperature or gases at room temperature and they are non-conductor of electricity. Whereas the polar molecules are soft in nature, they are also non-conductor of electricity, they have low melting and low boiling points. Let us discuss the ionic crystals or the ionic solids. The ionic crystals or ionic solids are those solids in which the constituent particles are positively charged cations and negatively charged anions, which have strong intermolecular or electrostatic force of attraction between them. They are very hard and brittle in nature. They have very high melting and high boiling points. While discussing the electrical property of ionic solids, it is mandatory to note that ionic solids or crystalline solids are poor conductor of electricity in the solid state, but in the solution or in the aqueous form or in the molten state, they are very, very good conductor of electricity. The examples of ionic solids are sodium chloride, copper sulfate, or any other salt. Let us discuss the third one, that is metallic solid or the metallic crystals. In metallic solids, the constituent particles are positively charged kernels and mobile free electrons. All metals are examples of metallic solids. You very well know that the force of attraction present between the kernels and the electron is again electrostatic in nature. It is slightly less as compared to the ionic force present in the ionic crystals. Metallic solids are very hard in nature except few metals of S block which are soft in nature. They are very good conductor of heat and electricity. Other properties of metallic solids are they are malleable and ductile in nature, that is sheets can be formed by beating them and wires can be drawn from metallic solids. The enthalpy of fusion is moderate in case of metallic solids. The fourth type of crystalline solids are the covalent solids. These are the solids in which constituent particles are the non-metallic atoms. Those are linked through the covalent bond. Diamond and graphite are the examples of the covalent solids. We very well know that these are hard in nature. They are having extremely high melting points. They are poor conductor of electricity. They are insulators except the graphite. While discussing the examples of diamond and graphite, it is essential to note that diamond is sp3 hybridized. It has no free electron, so it is poor conductor of electricity. Due to the tetrahedral structure, diamond is one of the hardest substance in our nature. Whereas graphite is sp2 hybridized, it is having one free electron. Due to the presence of this free electron, it is good conductor of electricity and it is used as lubricant. It is soft in nature and is good conductor of electricity. So this was all for today. Next time we will discuss another topic on the chemistry, especially the new unit cell, types of unit cells and the characteristics of crystalline lattice. Hope you have enjoyed the topic and you will perform your assignment well in time. Thanks and have a nice day.